إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Before I begin, first of all, I apologize for speaking for my elders. And second of all, as one of our teachers say, تزاحموا تراحموا, that if you crowd together, you may be forgiven by Allah. So those in the back, perhaps you may come close together, so that angels will write us down as being close together during this time of gathering. And we're blessed to be gathered on the day of Jumu'ah, the day that is named after gathering, Jumu'ah. It's named after the verb of gathering. Jama'ah means to gather. And so we're blessed to be gathered with our brothers here today. That many times we don't see these brothers outside of this place. And so we should be thankful to Allah that He has gathered us with our beautiful brothers and our beautiful sisters here. And that He has given us a chance to see each other and a chance to be amongst each other. And Allah said, and the Prophet said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَمِيلٌ يُحِبُّ الْجَمَالِ, that indeed Allah is Jameel, He is beautiful. وَيُحِبُّ الْجَمَالِ, and He loves beauty. And yesterday I was walking with one of our teachers in North Berkeley, into some of the most beautiful areas I've ever been in. In this beautiful garden area. And we were walking, we were speaking, and he said, we were just walking through, and he said, look at this beauty on this, just right here. Imagine if the entire world was like this, how beautiful the world would be. And if the world was that beautiful, imagine how much more beautiful Jannah is. Jannah is, we can't even imagine. We have the names in this dunya, we have the name of a grape, for example. We don't know, but the grape of this dunya is nothing like the grape of Jannah. The grape of Jannah is far beyond that. We can't even imagine. The only thing it shares is the name. And then he said, if Jannah is that beautiful, how beautiful is Allah? How beautiful is Allah? And we know that in Jannah, the greatest pleasure we're going to receive is the beatific vision of Allah. And we know this is part of our beliefs. That Imam Tahawi says in his treatise on Aqidah, on what the Sunnis believe. He said, وَرُؤْيَةُ الْحَقِّ لِأَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, that the beatific vision is haqq, is true for the people of Jannah. بِغَيْرِ حَافَةٍ وَلَا كَيْفِيَةٍ. But we don't understand how, so we don't ask. We don't know the kayfiyah. We don't know the howness. How, what is the vision of Allah? What does that mean? We don't understand. We just know that we'll be blessed with it in Jannah. And may Allah make us people who are blessed with that. بِغَيْرِ حَافَةٍ وَلَا كَيْفِيَةٍ كَمَا نَتَطَّ بِهِ فِي كِتَابِ رَبُّنَا. How just as our Lord said in His Kitab, His book, the divine speech, the most beautiful of speech, وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ, that on that day, the faces will be glowing. إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ, it will be glowing because they'll be gazing upon their Lord. And this is what Allah says in the Quran, that this is the blessing that we're going to be given in that world. But this isn't given for free. This isn't given for free. You need to have the mercy of Allah. And the best way to achieve the mercy of Allah is to remember Allah. فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. That's what Allah says. If you remember me, I will remember you. But the thing about remembering is, to remember you need to forget. But Allah never forgets. So we can't even understand that. How can we understand the vision of Allah? That if you remember Allah, Allah will mention you in his gathering. That we want to be mentioned by Allah, the most beautiful. And the most beautiful of this creation was the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He was the most beautiful. The Yusuf Alayhi Salaam was given 50% of beauty. And he was no doubt beautiful. But what was he compared to our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Our Prophet was given 100% of beauty. All of it. And so, in Jannah, we will be able to see all of beauty. And then on top of that, Allah is infinitely more beautiful. And so we want to be able to see Allah. And to see Allah in Jannah, we need to make dhikr of Him. And Allah says in Surah Taha, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمًا. Whoever turns away from my dhikr, whoever turns away from my mention, he will have a miserable life. And we know there's plenty of people who have money and fame and this and that. They have everything they can want, but they live depressed lives because they don't have the dhikr of Allah in their tongues, and they don't have the dhikr of Allah in their hearts. They don't have the dhikr of the one who brought the message about Allah. They don't have the dhikr of the Prophet on their tongues and hearts. And so we're lucky that we're given a chance to constantly remember Allah. So Allah tells us, whoever turns away from my dhikr, he will be raised on the day of judgment. Whoever turns away from my dhikr, he will have a miserable life. And we know that to be true. That if you don't have Allah in your life, you have nothing. Allah is the one that gives you everything, and you're nothing without Allah. And so we should be grateful that Allah has given us the chance to even make mention of Him. وَلَا ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. Mentioning the dhikr of Allah is greater than anything. But in reality, this can also be understood as Allah's mention of another thing is greater. That when we make mention of Allah, we can't do it justice. But when Allah makes mention of Himself, He does perfect justice to us. And then we know from the hadith in the Arba'in of Imam Nawawi, he says that when you make dhikr of Allah, when you mention Allah in a gathering, Allah mentions you in a gathering way greater than that, much higher than that. So we want to be part of that the wala dhikr Allahi Akbar. We want to attain that mention from Allah. That's what we want to attain. And we don't want, and then the ayah continues to say, وَنَحْشَرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. That he will be raised. The hashar is where everyone is gathered. Yawm al-hashar, that's one of the names of Yawm al-qiyamah. When everyone is gathered and raised together. And we'll be raised and gathered together. But if we don't remember the dhikr of Allah, then what happens? وَنَحْشَرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. That he will be raised blind. And blindness in this world, may Allah protect us from anything like that. It's nothing compared to the blindness of the afterlife. Because over here, we might not see the beautiful trees over here. We might not see the beautiful carpet we have here, the beautiful masahif we have on our bookshelves. We may not see the beautiful brothers we have amongst each other. We may not have that blessing. But you know, that's fine. This is all hawadith. This is all things that are ephemeral and fleeting. And these things will leave. But Allah is hayy qadeem. He is everlasting, ever subsisting, pre-eternal and post-eternal. This is Allah, and we want to be able to have that vision of that. So we don't want to be raised on the Yawm al-Qiyamah blind. So we want to make dhikr of Allah, so that we're not blind on that day. And then what does Allah say next?
قَالَ رَبِّي مَا حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا.
The person who's raised blind will say, this is what Allah says in his kitab. On that day they will say, oh my Lord, why am I raised blind? Why am I raised blind when I used to be able to see in the dunya? Why? But Allah tells you in the few ayat before, because you didn't make dhikr of Him. You forgot about Allah. Not even forgot, you turned away. You know, sometimes when people talk about the dhikr of Allah, or people trying to give you a good message, you don't really want to hear it. Sometimes it's sickening. When people start reciting Quran, sometimes you're in a gathering and people start backbiting or whatever type of things we waste our time with. May Allah protect us from those kind of things. Whatever we waste our time with, then someone changes the subject to something that's good, something that reminds us of Allah. Sometimes we get a little annoyed at that. And we need to think, why is that? Because we have something wrong with us. We have something wrong with us then. So we don't want to turn away from the dhikr of Allah. This isn't saying whoever forgets Allah. This is saying whoever turns away from Allah. And we don't want to turn away from Allah. And so yes, why was I raised blind when I could see it in I could see in the dunya? Why? So let's say, like, Allah told us why. Because we turned away. We didn't want to be people who turned away. قَالَ رَبِّي مَا حَشَّرْتَنِي أَعْلَى وَقَدْ كُنْتِ بَصِيرًا. Then what does Allah say? قَالَ كَذَلِكَ. That's how it is. أَتَكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا. Then my signs came to you, my ayat came to you, the verses of the Quran came to you, the trees and the sun and the moon, all these are signs of Allah. These came to us, and we had the blessing of having time to reflect on these things. فَنَسِيتَهَا. But you forgot them, and you didn't pay attention to them. That's what Allah will say, that you didn't pay attention. وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. And this is the day that you're going to be forgotten. And we don't want to be amongst those who are forgotten on that day. We need to be remembered on that day. If we're not remembered on that day, we're lost. And there's nothing that will help us. Nothing that will help us other than the mercy of Allah. And so we ask Allah for mercy. And we ask Allah for afiyah. And we ask Allah for rahmah. We ask Allah for the Allah is the ar-Rahman. The all-merciful and ar-Rahim. The all-merciful. Why does Allah use these two names? And have in English, they have the same meaning. But what the ar-Rahman is the most merciful, who gives you whether you deserve it or not. And none of us ever deserve anything. You know, we should recognize that. But Ar-Rahman is the one that gives you whether you're a believer or not. He gives the food to the kafir and he gives the food to the mu'min. And he blesses the kafir with wealth and with family and with friends and with comforts in life. And he also blesses the believer with those things. But the Ar-Rahim is the one who blesses the mu'min. This specific mercy with the shafa'ah of the Prophet ﷺ on the Yawm al-Qiyamah. With the intercession where the Prophet ﷺ will ask for mercy for us. And whatever the Prophet ﷺ asks of Allah, he will be given. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ فَتَرْضَى. That you will be given and you will be made content with it. You'll be happy with what you're given. And so we know that this is one of the most hopeful ayat of the Qur'an. That we know when the Prophet ﷺ asks, he's given. And he's going to ask for our mercy. So we should be grateful for the fact that we're in the ummah of the one who's going to be the only one able to speak on that day. The only one who's going to be able to ask for mercy. All the other anbiya, all the other prophets, everyone else is going to be concerned about themselves. And rightfully so. This is a day where no one, the mother won't even consider the child. That the child will be forgotten by the mother. And imagine what is the type of mercy that your mother has for you. What is the type of mercy my mother has for me? You know, what is that? What is that? What is that love that the mother has? But even the mother will forget you. So imagine the Prophet will have more love for their communities. But our Prophet is the best of prophets, the most beautiful of prophets. And he's going to be the one who remembers us on that day. He's going to be the one to make sajda and ask from Allah. And he won't even know what he'll ask. He says that I'll make a dua, I don't even know what it is. But when he'll ask for us, it'll be accepted, inshallah. May Allah make some people who are included in that dua. But then the ayah continues that you've forgotten. You forgot me in this world. So then I'll forget you. Then Allah says you're forgotten in the next world. وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي مَنْ أَسْرَفَ وَلَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّي وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَشَدُّ وَأَبْقَى. And like that, the recompense is for the people. وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي مَنْ أَسْرَفَ. This is the recompense for people who transgress upon themselves. We didn't transgress upon Allah. We transgress upon ourselves. That our dhikr doesn't benefit Allah, and our forgetting the dhikr doesn't harm Allah. It harms only ourselves and only benefits ourselves. So this is for our own good. وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَشَدُّ وَأَبْقَى. And the punishment of the akhirah is ashad, more severe, not just severe, more severe than we can imagine. وَأَبْقَى, and more lasting. We cannot imagine the type of lasting. It's a potential infinity. The theologians describe it as a potential infinity, that it goes on to خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. It goes on forever. And we shouldn't get confused. This is not an eternal with Allah. This punishment also has a beginning. So it's not infinite in every aspect. But it'll last forever. It's more lasting than we can imagine. And so we don't want to be from people who receive that type of punishment. We don't want to be people who are raised on the day of judgment and blind. We don't want to be among the people who are forgotten on that day, who forgot Allah here. And we want to be people who make shukr and dhikr, who are grateful for the fact that we're able to make dhikr. And may Allah make us amongst these people. أَقُولَ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ لِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Bismillahi wa alhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. If you came late and you don't know what we're talking about, what we're speaking about today is something very simple that we've all heard before since we're very young. The most important thing in our lives is dhikr. But why is the most important thing in our lives dhikr? Because that's how we attain success. And you know, a lot of times we hear this from the sages, and we hear this from our parents, and we hear this from the uncles, and we hear this from the aunts, and we hear this from everyone. But how seriously do we take it? When you actually look at how Allah describes it and how Allah gives a message, we realize the importance of it. That without the dhikr, we won't have the pleasure of this life, and we definitely won't have the pleasure of the next life. And we want the pleasure of both. And so we ask Allah for people who have the pleasure of this life in our hands, and the pleasure of our pleasure of this life, such as money and all this stuff. These are all things okay to have. They're okay to have in your hands and in your pockets. It's okay to have clothes over here on nice clothes on your body, but it's not okay to have these things in here in your heart. If you have it in your heart, then you're not gonna come to Allah with qalbun saleem. You're gonna have something, whatever is in your heart is your Lord. And we don't want our Lord to be anything other than the one who deserves lordship, which is Allah. And so we ask Allah that He makes us people who have Him in our hearts. Who have this constant remembrance in our hearts and love for Him in our hearts, and people who constantly make dhikr of Him and constantly thank Him for every blessing that we're given, and make us a people who recognize that we don't deserve these blessings. And because we don't deserve these blessings, the hamd is for Him. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. That all praise is due to Allah. May Allah make us a people of hamd. And may Allah make us a people of shukr. And may Allah make us a people of shukr, not only for what we understand that He gives us, but also the things that we don't understand, the things we don't perceive. That may we be people who thank Allah for the blessing of the Prophet ﷺ to be in the best of ummas. May we make dhikr and shukr of this. And may Allah keep us firm on this. And may Allah keep us firm on His deen. May Allah make us the people who recognize that there is no peace without Him. That without Him, there's no happiness in our lives. And for that, we say, Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram حينا وأدخلنا دار السلام ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. And may Allah make some people who recognize that Allah and His angels send their blessings and salutations on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and that we are commanded to do the same. Allah says, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على أصحاب محمد وعلى أزواج محمد وعلى أمة محمد وبارك وسلم وصل عليه. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.